You are. A little later than I was expecting, to be honest. Did it really take you that long to wipe out Zardries and his men? Maybe you're not as good as I thought you were.
If you throw down your weapons, I'll bring you in alive.
Not a chance. You make me sick. You killed good men, fellow soldiers, all because some scumbag on Coruscant said they were traitors? Your loyalties are all wrong. When you're bleeding out in a trench on some muckball planet, it ain't High Command that pulls you out. It's the guy next to you.
You betrayed the Republic. It doesn't matter why.
So here you are. A little later than I was expecting, to be honest. Did it really take you that long to wipe out Zardries and his men? Maybe you're not as good as I thought you were.
If you throw down your weapons, I'll bring you in alive.
Not a chance. You make me sick. You killed good men, fellow soldiers, all because some scumbag on Coruscant said they were traitors? Your loyalties are all wrong. When you're bleeding out in a trench on some muckball planet, it ain't High Command that pulls you out. It's the guy next to you.
We can work this out, Andric. Just lower your weapon, and we'll talk.
I'm not interested in working anything out with scum like you.
Treacherous vermin, I have completed the charging process. All systems operable.
Sounds like your time's up, Lieutenant. Have any last...
Lieutenant, you made it! I knew this imp-loving scum could never escape the sure justice of the Republic for long.
At least now you know whose side you've been working for.
Yes, without your timely intervention, I might never have realized the truth. Unfortunately, I am still bound by my programming to obey Captain Andric. The coward has naturally ordered me to kill you. To be used this way against the finest agents of my beloved Republic shames me. Oh, I wish I had never been activated.
I never chose to be a traitor.
Whether by choice or not, I am acting as a traitor, worthy only of scorn and summary obliteration.
Enough chatter. It's time to finish this.
Lieutenant, be advised that your weapon will require several decades of sustained fire in order to penetrate my shields at their current charge. Seeing as Republic Spec Force training is the best in the galaxy, I'm confident you'll find an alternative solution for my destruction. Good luck.
Don't worry, Forex. You won't have to put up with this much longer.
That's a great relief, Lieutenant.
Enough! Open fire!
I'm with the SIS. What is your status? Do you require medical attention?
My Medicare has me covered. Thanks.
Excellent. We'll get straight to work then. We're here to clean up the mess, make sure there's nothing useful to be recovered. Nice work, by the way. Jonas is waiting for you inside the Republic Embassy, up on the promenade. He asked that you meet him there for a debriefing.
I'll head for the embassy right away.
Glad I got a chance to meet you, Lieutenant. And again, nice work.
Sweepers, fed out. Standard grid formation.
Ailments. You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Which is why you shouldn't have tried to hide this from us. How can the SIS do its job if you lie to us?
You are in no position to demand anything from me, Agent Belker. I will conduct Special Forces affairs as I see fit.
Treason? Mass defection? You're covering up a threat to the entire Republic.
I'm back. The operation was a success.
Yes, the operation. That's just what we were discussing.
What were you thinking, Lieutenant? I gave you specific orders, and you ignored them.
Not everyone can deceive their allies, General. Some people actually have standards.
We have a responsibility to be honest with our fellow agencies and departments.
Your responsibility is to follow orders. This discussion is over. Lieutenant, contact me on your ship's holo when everything with M14X has been settled. Garza out.
I don't know how you work with that woman. The job got done, and it was no small feat. You've definitely earned your reward.
I just did my duty, Jonas. Nothing more.
I'm afraid modesty isn't going to get you out of this one. Republic War Droid M14X is to be repaired and direct control transferred to Havoc Squad's current commanding officer immediately. Want to go meet the newest member of your squad, Lieutenant?
Absolutely, Jonas.
Come on, follow me.
All right, that should wrap things up. Activating now.
Diagnostics complete. All systems operational. Unit M14X reporting for duty.
Welcome to Havoc Squad, M14X.
Lieutenant, I'm very pleased to see you again. Your work in disabling me was incredible. Republic soldiers obviously are the best in the galaxy. It will be an honor to fight alongside such an exceptional servant of the Republic. Together, we shall crush the mindless hedonist of the Sith Empire.
I'm glad to have you back on our side, 4X.
It is a pleasure to return to the service of freedom and democracy, sir.
It's been a pleasure working with you, Lieutenant. Hopefully the next time we meet, we'll be under more honest circumstances.
Make a good team, Belker.
I don't know. After the swath of destruction we burned across Nar Shaddaa, it might be better for the galaxy if we don't work together again. See you around, Lieutenant.
Stand by for examination and suggested products. You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Lieutenant, there you are. Do I need to reiterate my disappointment in your decision to intentionally disobey orders and reveal the Spec Force defections to the SIS? Or has that been made suitably clear?
Clear, General. It won't happen again.
I'm glad to hear it. As for the mission itself, I'm satisfied. You've stopped Tavis' plans for the M14X and returned a valuable asset to Republic service. Well done.
Until I have Tavis in my sights, I won't be satisfied.
Neither will I, Lieutenant. But that's only a matter of time. Of course, you did almost plunge the entire galaxy into a war just to accomplish this mission. Please try to avoid that sort of thing in the future.
I'll try to be more careful from now on.
Now, I've just received some intelligence that I want Havoc to act on immediately. It's Tavis. He and a team of commandos just raided a Republic research center on Clarion and stole a prototype cloaking device. But the prototype contains a tracking beacon. We now know the exact location of Tavis's ship. This is it, Lieutenant.
This seems too easy.
Let's hope the situation really is as simple as it appears. Tavis's ship is currently sitting alone in an empty sector of space, most likely waiting to rendezvous with a larger vessel. You have to get there before that happens, Lieutenant.
When I hear lone ship in empty space, I think trap.
We'll deal with that situation if it occurs, but we have to take this chance. This is Haron Tavis himself, Lieutenant. Succeed here, and everything else becomes an afterthought.
I won't fail.
That's why I'm sending you. Be sure to secure the prototype cloaking device after you've dealt with Tavis. If it fell into the Empire's hands, it could be disastrous. I'm transmitting the coordinates to you now. Effect entry to Tavis's ship, then do whatever is necessary to neutralize him and retrieve the prototype. Good hunting. Garza out.
I feel I owe you an apology. After we spoke with Captain Kalor, I was unnecessarily curt with you. You've been very supportive. That hasn't always been the case with Republic personnel I've dealt with since defecting.
I wouldn't be much of a CO if I didn't watch out for my people.
It's greatly appreciated, sir. People distrust me as soon as I speak. They only hear my accent. Even when I'm not a potential spy, I'm a resource. Endless questions about Imperial culture, personnel, military procedures. It's exhausting.
You're a good soldier, Dorne. Don't worry about what other people expect.
Thank you, sir. I really don't complain by nature. Mistrust and inconvenience are a small price to pay for a clear conscience. I don't regret defecting to the Republic at all. Despite my past, I was allowed to join the military, earn commendations and serve in the Republic's most elite squad. I'm very fortunate.
What led you to defect in the first place?
We should talk about it later, sir. I've occupied enough of your time.
Bad news, sir. I just received a dispatch from command. It's my old sniper squad, the Deadeyes. They've been captured. Happened during a routine officer hunt. Somehow the imps got the drop on them and rounded up the entire unit. Careless.
How long have the Deadeyes been in Imperial custody?
Weeks. More than enough time to be marched in front of a firing squad. Look, something about this doesn't sit right with me. The Deadeyes' area of operation was on Nar Shaddaa. That's hot territory. Neutral ground. They shouldn't have had any business operating there.
You think there's more going on here?
Can't say yet. I need to know what happened to the Deadeyes. And if they're still alive. Missions on Nar Shaddaa are usually greenlit by the SIS. With your permission, I'd like to meet with them. See what they know.
Get a hold of Jonas Balker. He may be able to help us.
Your call. We'll rendezvous at the dive he hangs out in. With any luck, he'll have something for us.
I might ask a personal question about the former Havoc Squad member's defection. What was it like to have your commander and comrades join the enemy? How did you feel?
It was hard to see such great soldiers throwing away everything they'd fought for.
I can only imagine what it must have been like. I've always wondered how my family took the news of my defection. It must have been difficult for them to understand.
What was your family like?
Austere. Proud. Warm as well, at least in private. Members of the Dorne family have served with distinction in the Imperial military for generations. It's an important family tradition. It isn't easy to reach prominence in the Empire with no aptitude for the Force, but my family did it. I hope they're all still well.
It can't be easy to fight against your family's side.
It is a consequence I accepted when I chose to defect. I don't give it a second thought.
Thank you. I promise nothing less than perfection, Master.
Of course.
Right away, sir. I've completed my assignment. We'll be right back.
Lieutenant now, right? You're doing so well for yourself, I'm very proud. I have to thank you for working this little meeting into your very busy schedule. It took me some trouble to arrange.
In the name of the Republic, I order you to surrender.
You know, you're so threatening over Holo that I might even consider it. Let me get back to you later. You have caused me a great deal of difficulty, Lieutenant. Some have even called you my nemesis. Was that your goal?
My goal is to bring traitors to justice.
So is mine, Lieutenant. Needles. Even Captain Andric. What is wrong with you? They were heroes, Lieutenant.
Your squad mates betrayed the Republic, just like you.
You're a fool. In my entire career, only one other enemy has been as difficult as you. The Imperial Shadow Fist. One of the most elite commando units in all of the Sith Empire. Five of the Emperor's deadliest agents.
Please, end this before anyone else has to die.
I have only just begun, Lieutenant. Havoc Squad and the Shadow Fist fought many times. We battled to a standstill over and over again. We were the worst of enemies. But times have changed, Lieutenant. Meet my five newest friends.
Havoc Squad, defensive positions.
Ready, sir.
You're overdue for a painful death, Lieutenant. Goodbye.
We'll be right back.
post. Functioning at peak efficiency.
Lieutenant, report. Were you able to neutralize Tavis?
I'm afraid Tavis wasn't at the coordinates.
I see. I take it he left you something for your trouble, though. You retrieved a military asset of incredible importance in the face of extreme danger. You did well. Our only choice now is to proceed as originally planned. Our technicians have determined your final two target locations, Tatooine and Alderaan. I'll give you a full briefing when you arrive at each mission zone. Move out immediately. Garza out.
If I may say so, sir, you've had quite an impressive career. You're the commander of the most elite squad in the entire Republic. You must be quite proud.
Serving in Havoc Squad?
If I may say so, sir, you've had quite an impressive career. You're the commander of the most elite squad in the entire Republic. You must be quite proud.
I just go where they tell me and do my job. Nothing more.
Clearly, you do more than that. Well, you wouldn't have such an exceptional service record. I remember when I first enlisted and qualified for medical specialization. My brother Alexei completed his technical specialization on the same day. We were both proud to finally serve in the Imperial military. My brother advanced quickly, but I became disillusioned as time went on.
Why did you become disillusioned?
The Imperial military was supposed to stand for honor and discipline. But my superiors discarded those concepts any time a Sith asked it. I'd always been taught that the Jedi and the Republic were genocidal hypocrites. But the only brutalities I witnessed were committed by my own comrades.
Did you try to change things, or did you defect right away?
I raised my concerns with my superiors, but they only questioned my resolve. Soon, I would have been forced to prove my loyalty by carrying out orders directly against my conscience. I chose to defect instead.
I'd say you made the right move, Dorn.
Once I'd made the decision, I slipped away during my squad's next night patrol. I was gone before anyone realized it. I surrendered to the first Republic patrol I came across and declared my intention to defect. That was over 3 years ago. It's strange to realize how long it's been. The Republic truly feels like my home now.
It is a tremendous pleasure to be here aboard your ship. And what a ship it is. A BT-7, if I'm not mistaken. One of the pilot designs. A very fine vessel, appropriate for the Republic's best. We will ride this Durasteel Eagle into the heart of the Empire, and bring our fight for freedom to the door of the Emperor himself.
You'll make a great addition to Havoc.
I'm proud to know that you feel that way. I have loaded all pertinent data. Let us proceed with our noble duty. Sir, allow me to reiterate my pleasure at serving in your command. Since my verbal brain was first activated, I have longed to engage the enemies of freedom directly. Under your noble leadership, I can finally fulfill the mission the Republic's fearless scientists designed me for.
It's good that you're so enthusiastic about our mission.
I can't take all of the credit for my enthusiasm, of course. I owe everything to my primary designer, Dr. Boab Deedon. Thanks to Dr. Deedon, I can understand the importance of our fight and the extent of the threats we face, and I can fight harder for it.
There's nothing better than fighting for a cause you believe in.
I couldn't agree more, sir. It is an amazing thing to know that you are exceptional, sir. I'm sure you know the feeling, given your incredible service record.
my programming, my weaponry, my armor, all state-of-the-art, and my power core, a true marvel. Other droids may look like me or have some of my capabilities, but none of them have my power core. I'm very proud to be so unique.
The differences among us are what give the Republic its strength.
Exactly, sir. Billions of unique individuals coming together to contribute to the greater good. Oh, it's truly inspiring. I see Havoc Squad in much the same way. We are set apart from other infantry teams by one thing. You. Thanks to your wise and courageous leadership, Havoc Squad is the finest military unit in the Republic. You are what makes Havoc special.
I'm just another soldier, nothing more.
The soldiers of the Republic are all very impressive, but surely none of them can compare with you. Let's return to the fight, sir. It's already been too long since I saw Imperial soldiers stomped into the muck where they belong. Sir, if you have a moment, I've developed an initiative to improve morale amongst our fellow soldiers. As we both know, Havoc Squad is the finest military team ever assembled. Our triumphs prove to the public that victory is near. Unfortunately, as a team, even we can only accomplish so many victories in a given amount of time. Therefore, I would like to undertake additional assignments on my own time.
What kind of additional assignments?
I'd like to coordinate with Command and the SIS to find extra targets. Imperial personnel no one else could challenge. And neutralize them.
Some tough winds would really get our troops fired up.
My calculations suggest the Republic's forces' morale would increase more than 18% for each impossible target I neutralize. Such incredible victories would demoralize the putrid citizens of the Empire as much as they would encourage our heroic comrades.
It's a good plan, Forex. Make it happen.
I'll inform you as soon as I locate a suitable target, sir. Sir.
I was just wondering how I might serve you better, Master. I'll start this task immediately.
I've got your back.
Captain. Please select an available travel route. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Apologies, sir.
Here.
Not my best work. Much better, sir.
Objective complete.
You're early. Haven't even had time to order us up a round. So, how's that 4X unit treating you? Racking up plenty of kills, I hope.
Deadeyes. Valker, what do you know?
He's right. We didn't come for small talk.
Fair enough. I dug up what info I could, but frankly, there isn't much to report. Far as I can tell, the Deadeyes tried to off some Imperial big shot. Things went south, and they got themselves captured.
We both know the SIS has more intel than that.
There's more at stake here than you know. We're on the verge of an incident. The Imperials are out for blood, so the Republic is distancing itself from the operation. I shouldn't even be talking to you about all this. Those boys are on their own.
These are Republic soldiers, sir. Good men. All of them.
If the Republic won't do anything, then Havoc Squad will.
Look, I know this stinks. But my hands are tied on this one. I've got major players breathing down my neck. Otherwise, I tell you to investigate that prison the Imperials set up in Shadowtown.
Now we're getting somewhere.
You didn't hear this from me. Now, rumor has it, and I'm just talking here, that the Imperials built themselves a makeshift prison not too far from here. That's where they dump any local riffraff that get out of line. Could be they took the Deadeyes there.
It's a start. We'll look into it.
The less I know, the better. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got an alibi to work on. Remember, this meeting never happened.
Thank you.
Apologies, sir. Not my best work. Much way, sir.
It will be an honor.
On it.
Are currently open for business. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Things didn't work out.
Stand by for examination and suggested products. You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
I was hoping I'd catch up with you. You're the new members of Havoc Squad.
Something wrong?
The death cult of the Morgu Kai is here. Honor-bound warriors from the Nikto homeworld. I ran into them once, a long time ago.
What happened to you?
Years back, the Morgu Kai took me prisoner in order to lure a worthy opponent, a Jedi. They killed her, then let me go. Now they're training other Nikto on Nar Shaddaa to hunt and kill Republic targets. Someone has to stop them at their temple and drive them off-world.
Whatever training they've got, it's no Republic boot camp.
You could say the same about the Sith Academy, but we don't get cocky around them either. The temple's not far. Some sort of converted warehouse. Good luck in there.
I've completed my task.
Achieved incredible results.
Cell block. Let's move.
Seeing them anywhere.
No sign of them here. Valkar must have sent us on a wild... Wait. I may have something. It's an outgoing holo message. Recent.
This is Captain Titch, confirming the details for outgoing prisoner transfer 993B. We've got 3 Gamorrean trespassers, a couple of spice peddlers, and our catch of the day, the legendary Dead Eyes.
At least we know they're alive.
Or they were at the time of this transmission.
As per protocol, we've split the Deadeyes up and transferred them to off-world labor camps. I've encrypted the coordinates for their designated camps into this transmission. Those scum can spend the remaining years working off their debt.
Message ends there. Guess the imps don't make things quick for their POWs. Lucky us.
Make a copy of those coordinates.
On it. Encryption here is good. Too good. I can't crack it. Looks like we may need Valkar's services again.
me!
owe you one.
Report derailments. You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Derailments. You
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Thank you. doubt we've seen the last of them.
What can I get for you? Come back anytime.
Off the hollow with a very angry Imperial diplomat. Apparently, some Republic troopers broke into the Imperial Detention Center.
Hey, I just went to Hari's for a drink. I got a new waitress there. Real looker.
Don't get cute with me, Balker. You know something.
That breach was a Havoc Squad op. Balker had nothing to do with it.
Nice of you to save me the trouble of hunting you down. Senior Agent Zane, SIS. That little stunt you pulled... Apparently, some Republic troopers broke into the Imperial Detention Center.
Hey, I just went to Hari's for a drink. I got a new waitress there. Real looker.
Don't get cute with me, Balker. You know something.
Is this a bad time?
On the contrary. Now I know exactly where to stick my foot. Senior Agent Zane, SIS. That little stunt you pulled ruined any chance we had of negotiating the Deadeye's safe return.
Check your facts, Zane. The Imperials already shipped them off-world.
It's Senior Agent Zane, thank you. And storming an Imperial facility, guns blazing, it makes things worse. Your involvement ends now. Clear?
Our involvement ends when the Deadeye's are free.
Then you can tell your CO to expect a little love note from me. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got an Imperial ambassador to mollify. I trust you'll see yourselves off my planet.
What were you thinking coming back here? I told you I couldn't be connected to any of this.
We found some encrypted coordinates in the prison central computer. We think they'll tell us where the Deadeye's are.
Any chance you can decrypt those coordinates for us?
Not with Zane watching me. Look, a friend in signal intelligence owes me a favor. I'll put you in contact with him. He may be able to make something of those coordinates. It's the best I can do.
We couldn't have done this without Balker. I think you owe him your thanks.
Fine. Balker. Thanks.
Hey, anything for you, Jorgen.
I'll connect with Balker's contact once we get back to the ship. I'll report if I hear anything.
Find a better bargain. Come back anytime.
Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Thank you. Come in, Lieutenant. This is General Garza. I see you've landed in Anchorhead. Tatooine is a vast and dangerous desert of a planet, and I'm afraid you can't count on having Republic support during your mission there.
Havoc Squad can handle anything.
All the same, Lieutenant, I hate sending my people into uncharted areas like Tatooine without some kind of support. In the absence of military assets, I've arranged a local contact to assist you in your mission. Ole Claren, the mayor of Anchorhead. Mayor Claren may not be a soldier, but he knows the area extremely well and can put his city's resources, whatever those may be, at your disposal.
I'll talk to the guy.
Be sure to remember that this operation is top secret, Lieutenant. I told Mayor Claren only that you're undertaking an important mission, which is all that he needs to know. Understood?
I'll proceed with caution, General.
Very good. That's all I have for you at the moment. Proceed with the operation. Garza out.
Sir.
You have but to ask, Master. Consider the matter handled.
Sorry to interrupt. My name's Fowler. I was told you might be passing through. I represent the Republic here, and I thought we could chat. I thought the military might lend me a hand. Unofficially, anyway.
I can spare some time for you.
Here's the thing. I'd rather not do this by holocommunicator. I've got a little, embassy in downtown Anchorhead. Swing on by. I promise you it's worthwhile.
I'll try, but no promises.
Good to hear it. The sooner, the better. This is much bigger than some local trouble. Follow out.